I'm Brenda Lucas. I'm Operations Manager for the Southern Ontario Water Consortium, and we're out here today on Alder Creek with monitoring team from the University of Waterloo that's part of the SOWC watershed node that are doing some stream monitoring on site. The Southern Ontario Water Consortium is a partnership of 8 universities, and we're working together to build a platform that's a suite of facilities for doing water demonstration, testing and development of water technologies across Southern Ontario. The Grand River is a large river in Southern Ontario that's facing growth pressures and urbanization pressures like many rivers around the world. So the more we can understand how to supply clean drinking water, how to manage our wastewater in ways that doesn't impact that watershed, the more we can start to develop both watershed management techniques that will help that environment, as well as create the opportunity for new innovations and developing new products and technologies and services that will help us do that.
We all live in watershed environments. Within those watersheds, we have homes, we have urban centers, we have agricultural development, all of them competing and using water in different ways. As we move on into the future and the stress on the watersheds grow, what we desperately need is information to be able to predict how to maintain and manage these watersheds in a sustainable way for the future. The data streams that we're talking about that will come from these fully instrumented watersheds provide us an insight that will allow us to develop strategies and municipalities and cities to be able to put plans together to be able to maintain the watersheds for the future. And that's really the core goal of what we're trying to achieve here. We're seeing that the reoccurrence of extreme hydrologic events, heavy rainfall, large melt events are occurring more frequently. The data sets that we're looking at will help us decide and determine and predict whether the area is more or less sensitive to flooding in a real-time environment. Merging soil data with climatic data to surface runoff data together simultaneously give us much more insight into the possibility of flooding occurring and being able to respond to it in advance to protect downstream assets. So looking at dense data sets and large data sets coming from multiple sensors often are interpreted as individual data streams. And what the ability of the IBM data platform does, provide us with a way of merging those data sets together in a way that we've never been able to do before. So it's truly unprecedented in terms of our ability to merge the data, and superimposing it, the emerging analytical tools that are available are going to help us and lots of stakeholders make decisions that they weren't able to make before with insight that's now invaluable for future management of watersheds.